growing up in a really close-knit family, I feel like we always had babies being born, and I always had one on my hip. Honestly, from the time I was a little girl, I envisioned having 2 to 3 kids. As I got a little bit older, I was about 11 or 12, I met Justin, and I seen my future with him. As all of us girls do, I start visualizing our future together, our wedding, becoming a mom, and planning what our dream home would look like. Fast forward to years later, tons of memories made, and some really hard times too, I married my little childhood sweetheart. Fast forward, we find out we're pregnant. That rush of finding out you're pregnant for the very first time is like no other. It's feeling of I'm scared to death, but so excited you can't even sleep. We told everyone immediately, had a gender reveal the whole nine yards. We never really even thought about anything bad happening. Even though I was sick night and day, I had several complications, but we were just on top of the world, excited, and it was really all worth it. While in our second trimester, we lost our baby boy. Devastation and grief consumed us for a very good bit. After some time passed, we were able to try again. My feelings were all over the place, but I knew this is what we wanted. A few months passed with negative tests, then we got a positive. We kept it pretty quiet. We were so guarded and found it really hard to let ourselves get excited. I wasn't sick, I felt amazing, and was having an entire different experience. We entered the second and third trimester and literally was on the edge of our seat the entire time, just waiting for something bad to happen. I know that sounds awful to admit, but it's true. I loved being pregnant this time around, but that weird guilt feeling would creep up and steal my joy. At 39 weeks and 6 days, the absolute love of our lives was born and has absolutely rocked our world. We've been on cloud 9 ever since that sweet baby girl graced this earth. Becoming a mom and watching Just be a dad is a whole different kind of being in love. It's like you fall head over heels in love all over again with each other and this little human that you brought into the world. My dream of being a mom had finally become a reality, so we've been completely consumed with Emery Ray for the last 3 years. Watching her learn and try to give her the absolute most incredible life we possibly can. She's what makes our world spin around. If you know Emery, you know she has a big imagination, and in about 90% of her stories, she talks about her brother. Cold chills rolled all over me the first few times this happened, but I know it's her guardian angel, and he's being a big brother from above. We've been asked if we want children, more children, and we immediately say no. We've talked about having one more privately, but the fear immediately comes over us and we're both just like no. My thought process is always, just be happy with one, the one God gave you, and don't press your luck. I know Emery would be fine without a sibling. I was fine growing up as an only child. My parents were and still are active with me, so I never felt alone. Plus, I had close cousins. We really are content and enjoying this stage of our life. Then, just as we thought life couldn't get any sweeter, God wasn't finished with our family yet. We are expecting baby number 2 in April. I won't lie, we both are in complete shock and still are completely terrified. We've kept it sort of quiet because even after having a wonderful pregnancy with Emery Ray, that gut-wrenching pain of losing our son creeps up like a bad dream. We are still guarded and just entered our second trimester. Emery knows I have a baby in my belly and kisses it all the time. It's seriously the most precious thing. When we ask her if she's having a boy or a girl, she keeps changing her mind. She'll be tickled with either, and so will we. We are so thankful for these blessings God's given us. I made Justin go to Walgreens on our way home one night, and we came home and I took the pregnancy test and I just put it on the back of the toilet because we both thought it was going to be negative. I just had this gut feeling that I needed to know and went back a little bit later to see if it had ever processed, and it did, and it was positive.
And you didn't tell me at first because you didn't believe it.
I hollered at him. He came in there and he said, "There's no way this is true." And he looked at it and he was like, "Well, it's really faint, so it's probably not. It's probably not positive." So then I proceeded to take the other one that I bought, because I bought two, and it was positive. And the next morning I called the doctor, made an appointment to confirm it, went in, had the blood work, and it was positive. And we were already, how many weeks?
I think it was 4 weeks.
Would you say we put us down some roots, found a house up on a hill, and travel around the world, put some pictures on the shelf, hold you close and keep the faith, raise some kids with our last name. Well, come on, baby, what you say we do? I feel like growing old with you.
Ready? Yeah.
Growing
old. What's
happening?
It's
pink. Pink.
Travel around the world. Put some pictures on the shelf. Hold you close and keep the faith. Raise some kids with our last name.
What a girl family.
I feel like growing old with you.
Growing old with you. What you say we put us down some roots, find a house up on a hill, travel around this world, put some pictures on the shelf. Maybe one day a baby's gold, and have some babies of their own, and you'll get all my time till all my time is through. I feel like